Good afternoon, everybody. So I'm going to move to some and our attempt to understand the impact that they may have on the on their surrounding medium is a work in progress that I'm doing with the major contribution of Tom and Clive here. So let me so radio jet. Oops. Radio jets are one of manifestation, of course, of nuclear activity, of active black hole. They can be quite an impressive manifestation. So because of that, they play a role in shaping the galaxy, the host galaxy, where they are sitting in. And in fact, I would say one of the main or nicer evidence for AGN feedback is in the cavity that a radio jet can form in the hot medium by their impact, by their growing into this medium. So these are a typical cavity of many tens of kiloparsec, hundreds of kiloparsec. As you see an example on the right, and the idea is that this effect kind of prevent the cooling of the gas, the hot gas. But actually, the effect of jet can restart in the inner, the very inner region, when the jet is born, and this is what we are focusing on. And so we know the jet can produce outflow, can interact with the medium and produce outflow. But actually, for this talk, for our project, what is interesting is also the suggestion given by numerical simulation. So you see here a few shot from a numerical simulation from the group of Bicknell and Mukherjee. You see the scale. I'm talking now about kiloparsec or sub-kiloparsec scale, so completely different from before. And what you see here is a jet that starts in a clumpy medium, dense clumpy medium, and what kind of effect this jet can do. So first interact with a dense cloud, hit this cloud, and some of them will be destroyed, some will be pushed, forming the outflow. But then this interaction also produces a bubble-like round that expands into the host galaxy. And this is the shock and that can produce much more damage than the jet itself, that is very typically quite narrow. So if this is the case, because these are simulation, if this is the case that the impact of the jet evolves as the jet evolves, of course, this gives a kind of connection between this scale and the galactic and outside the galaxy scale. So this is what we are exploring. And so to do this, of course, you have to investigate and explore a complex parameter space that I really don't want to get into that, but there are certainly the radio power and the age of the source are important, because you, as the jet expand, and we are talking about jets that are either very young or in their still infancy, so below 10 to the 6, you have the most of this effect. You can see most of this effect. This is what the simulation are telling us. Of course, the impact can manifest itself on a different medium, on different phase of the medium. So the ionized, the cold, neutral, and molecular. So we are exploring a bit all of them, but in particular, the molecular part has been claimed in the past year, certainly with the starting of ALMA observation, to be the most massive component of certainly of the outflow. So component of this impact. So you see on the you see here on the right a few objects, the handful of objects that we have been studying so far. Is, as you can imagine, a bit of a painful job, because you need high spatial resolution observation, because you want to trace the gas around your radio source, and these are smaller radio sources. We are talking about at most a few kiloparsec, as you will see in a moment. So So you need high spatial resolution, and in this ALMA is great, of course, and possibly multiple transition of the CO. So that takes time. But anyway, what I wanted to show you now is the last object that we have been studying. This comes from cycle 6 of ALMA. A couple of slides on what we are getting for this object that is one of the largest we have been studying so far, and then how this connected to the other object that we have done, or at least a couple of them that we have done in the past, also with ALMA. Okay, so this radio galaxy, so-called Parkes 0023-26, is a young radio galaxy. We know this because it's small, but also because of the spectral distribution. The radio spectral distribution is peaked, so it's not just a beam source. It's really a young, pure young source that expands in the surrounding medium. But still, it's about 4 kiloparsecs, so it has entered already the galaxy, and that makes this object interesting for us. As I said, it's one of the largest we have done so far in this way. Is also an optical AGN. You see the spectrum from each shooter here. So this is the radio source, it's 2 lobes, quite common in these young sources. And this is the X shooter spectrum. So it has a very high ionization, is a powerful AGN. So as everything you want to have to trace the impact of AGN in a medium. It's also in a quite complex surrounding, but not a massive cluster, is a very low mass group or cluster, but I would like to skip that part. I'm really going to concentrate on the AGN. So this is what we see with ALMA. So let me describe. So we are looking at this inner part of this optical image. You see there are more companions, but we are focusing on this region, and the orange part here is the distribution, the total intensity of the CO 2-1 that we have observed with 0.2 arcsecond resolution, so quite a high spatial resolution, because we wanted really to see the distribution and the kinematic of the gas around the radio lobes. And the radio continuum you can see in this also extracted by ALMA, you can see in this contour. So, so what we find is a large mass of CO that was not a complete surprise, because this is also far infrared bright and has some dust, but is distributed over 20 kiloparsecs at least. Even at this high spatial resolution, we can see some of this tail possibly connecting to the with the companion. But right now, I really want to focus on what the gas, how the gas looks and moves around a radio source. And so what you see here is that there is the brighter part of the continuum, the molecular gas is in the central region, co-spatial with the radio core, is this area here, brownish. And this is the brighter part, either because the molecular gas piles up there, or because it's, the excitation is higher. And we actually see this effect in other AGN I'll get at the end of this talk. Here we have only one transition, so we cannot really distinguish between the two. We also see a sort of dip at the location of the radio lobes. Of course, interesting for us, was a bit of a surprise, and I'll get to this in a moment. This is still work in progress, so I'll tell you what we got so far. So in a way, it's an ideal system to study, where to study the radio and the medium around, because there is really a lot of molecular gas around it. So we look, of course, at the kinematic, and the kinematic gave us some surprise that I'll show you here. So this is again the total intensity of the molecular gas, and here are some of the profile that we see at different locations. As I say, I'm not going to focus on the tails where we see double profiles, so there is some extra complication over there, but let's focus on the around the AGN. So what we see is that we see a high velocity dispersion at the location of the radio source. And you can see actually here, this is the velocity dispersion distribution. Velocity dispersion of a few hundred to 300. So clearly there is something going on between the radio plasma and the molecular gas. We see a particularly large distribution of velocity at the location of the brighter part. So what you see here is a position velocity plot in this direction of the brighter part. And you see a tail deviating from all the other gas, really at the location of the radio core, but we don't see fast and massive outflows that in a way we were expecting, or at least I was expecting, for this such bright AGN. So, and we see this dip, kind of dip, or that the radio lobe tend to avoid the molecular gas, that I cannot show you here, but you should trust me. So the gas tend to concentrate more around the radio lobe. High dispersion, but kind of in a cocoon around. So this is what we see in a nutshell, very cut a lot, for this radio galaxy. So I would like now, in the last couple of slides, to put this object in the context of what we are doing and compare with the other object we have done, because that's the final goal that we want to achieve. So
that's 3 minutes.
Yeah. So let me tell you about the friend of this source. So actually, in the object that we have done so far, we have found fast and massive outflow. And these are two cases. These are again position velocity plot with this kind of structure, the one that deviates very much from regularly moving gas. And this outflow of molecular gas can be up to 1,000 kilometers per second. Here you see another case where it's not so extreme position velocity. And here you see the comparison with the model, with the idea that a jet entered the medium and disturbed the medium and push aside the cloud and create this cocoon. So pretty good similarity between the two. So in some object, we really see the evidence of this going, so that the jet affected the medium dramatically. But all this happens on a very small scale. As you see here, this is 100 parsec scale, so very small. And we think that the origin of this outflow is because you are in a region where you have dense clouds, and so the gas, even if dissociated, the molecular gas, can have a fast cooling and reform molecular. We also see that, so the mass outflow tend to be on a very small, and as I listed here, and they go up to a few hundred solar masses per year, so quite a large amount, but limited to a very small area. And not so much of the gas gets out of the galaxy. The condition also gets affected. You see here the ratio between line to transition, and in the region co-spatial with the radio, you have a very high, we have higher excitation and different line ratio. So this is what we see in other objects. So why we don't see the fast outflow in this third object? So the idea is that we have at the moment that this gas, this radio source is more evolved. The gas is already lower density. The cooling of the gas takes much longer. So you don't see any more outflow of molecular gas. And actually the feedback, let's say, that this AGN gives to the host galaxy, instead of in the form of fast outflow and massive outflow, is really in the form of pushing the gas, the molecular gas aside. So more almost a maintenance mode, like if we are already getting into the type of mode that you see on the large scale for radio jet. So this is the first kind of hand-waving interpretation we have. We are working on that. And then, of course, this scenario will need to be tested with more CO transition. We may expect a different line ratio. In this case, if the shocks are not so strong anymore at this kiloparsec scale. And for this, of course, we anxiously wait for ALMA to restart. Thank you.